Coming to next topic, expression for VP, that is phase velocity, guided wavelength denoted by lambda g, and group velocity, that is denoted by Vg. In previous lecture, we have derived the expression for VP in terms of cutoff frequency and cutoff wavelength. Right? VP in terms of cutoff frequency is given by C by under root of 1 minus Fc by F whole square, and VP in terms of cutoff wavelength is given, expression for VP in terms of cutoff wavelength, that is given by VP equals to C by under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda C whole square. Right? We have derived this expression in previous lecture, that is expression for VP in terms of cutoff frequency Fc, that is given by C by under root of 1 minus Fc by F whole square, and expression for VP in terms of cutoff wavelength, that is given by C by under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda C whole square. Right? Now using this expression, now let us derive expression for Vg, that is group velocity. Vg is nothing but group velocity. Now let us derive expression for Vg in terms of cutoff frequency and cutoff wavelength. Right? Now Vg is given by expression d omega by d beta. Right? Expression for Vg, that is group velocity, which is nothing but the rate at which wave propagates through the waveguide. Right? Group velocity is defined as the rate at which wave propagates through the waveguide, and the expression is given by d omega by d beta. Right? We know beta, expression for beta, now that is given by under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon. Expression for beta is given as under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon. Right? Now differentiate this beta with respect to omega. Now what you'll get? Differentiate this beta with respect to omega, that is d beta by d omega. Right? Now we know the expression for beta, that is given by under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon. Now differentiate this expression beta in terms of omega. Right? Now that is given by d by d omega of under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon. Right? Now differentiate this whole beta term with respect to omega. Now if I differentiate d by d omega of root x, which is nothing but 1 by 2 root x, that is given by 1 by 2 root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon, into differentiating this omega term, you'll get 2 omega mu epsilon. Right? Differentiate beta with respect to omega, you'll get this. Now this two will get cancelled. Right? Now from this expression, we can write it as omega mu epsilon. Now take omega square mu epsilon out. If I take it out, you'll get omega under root of mu e. Right? If I take this out, you'll get omega under root mu e 1 minus wc by w whole square. Right? 1 minus wc by w whole square. Now this I can write it as, now this omega will get 1 times, you'll get omega under root of mu e. Right, this mu e I can write it as root mu e into root mu e. Right, this I can write it as root mu e into root mu e. Again you will get mu e only. This mu e will get cancelled. Finally you will get omega into under root of mu e divided by omega by 1 minus, now 2 pi, omega c is nothing but 2 pi f c, and omega is nothing but 2 pi f, and here you will get f c by f whole square. Now this omega will get cancelled. Right? This omega will get cancelled. And finally you will get d beta by d omega, which is nothing but under root of mu e, under root of, divided by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Under root of mu e divided by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. D beta by d omega, which is given by under root of mu e, right, d omega by d beta by d omega, which is given by under root of mu e divided by 1 under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now this expression I am writing here again. We are getting d beta by d omega as finally under root of mu e divided by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now c is nothing but 1 by root mu e. Right, c is nothing but 1 by root mu e. See, we know that vg equals to d omega by d beta. Now what you'll get? Under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square divided by root mu e. Right, now this is nothing but c into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now the expression for group velocity in terms of cutoff frequency, that is given by c into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now the similarly expression for vg in terms of cutoff wavelength, you'll get 1 minus lambda by lambda c square. Since lambda is inversely proportional to frequency, you'll get vg equals to c into under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda c whole square, right? Now these are the expressions for vg in terms of cutoff frequency and cutoff wavelength, right? Now let me briefly explain. Expression for vp, we have derived it in previous lecture. Now we have the expression, we got it as c by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square in terms of cutoff frequency, and in terms of cutoff wavelength, that is given by c by under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda c square. Now coming to next expression for vg, that is group velocity. The rate at which wave propagates through the waveguide is nothing but the group velocity. Now that is given by the expression d omega by d beta. Vg is given by d omega by d beta. We know expression for beta, that is denoted by under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon. Now differentiate this beta equation with respect to omega, right? D by d omega of under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon, right? D by dx of root x, which is nothing but 1 by 2 root x into 2x, right? 1 by 2 into this term, that is root over omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon, into differentiation of this omega term, you'll get 2 omega mu epsilon, right? Now this 2 will get cancelled. Now finally you'll get omega mu epsilon divided by, now take omega square mu e out, right? If I take it out, you'll get omega under root of mu e into under root of 1 minus wc by w whole square. Omega mu e, omega, this mu e will get cancelled. We'll get omega c by omega whole square. Now this mu e, I can write it as root mu e into root mu e. Now this root mu e will get cancelled. Now finally you'll get, and again omega also will get cancelled. Now finally you will get under root of mu e divided by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now this is the expression for d beta by d omega. You are getting it as under root of mu e divided by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square, right? Now the group velocity is given by the expression d omega by d beta. Now we know the expression for d beta by d omega. Now convert that to d omega by d beta, you'll get under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square divided by root mu. We know that c equals to 1 by root mu e, and finally you'll get c into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now the expression for group velocity in terms of cutoff frequency is c into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square, and the expression for group velocity in terms of cutoff wavelength, that is given by c into under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda c square, right? Now we know the expression for vp in terms of cutoff frequency is 1 minus c by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square, and the expression for vg in terms of cutoff frequency is, either it may be in terms of cutoff frequency or cutoff wavelength, right? The product of group velocity and phase velocity, always you'll get c square. The product of group velocity and phase velocity, you'll get c square. See, vp in terms of cutoff frequency is this equation, and vg in terms of cutoff frequency is this equation. Now if I multiply these two, you'll get product of phase velocity with group velocity. Now this term will get cancelled. Finally you'll get c square, right? Finally you'll get c square. Now this is the expression about for vp and vg, right? Now what is left out? Guided wavelength. Now the left out expression is guided wavelength. Now that is denoted by lambda g, right? Now that is denoted by lambda g. Now we have to derive expression for lambda g, right? Now vp is nothing but lambda g into f, right? Vp is nothing but product of wavelength, guided wavelength, into frequency. Now that is nothing but vp, right? Now lambda g into, we know that lambda equals to c by f. Now what is f? C by lambda, right? Vp equals to lambda g into c by lambda. Now c, now expression for vp in terms of cutoff wavelength is c by under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda c square, which is equals to lambda g into c by lambda. Now this c will get cancelled. Now finally you will get lambda g equals to lambda naught by lambda naught, or lambda both are same. Lambda naught or lambda both are same. Lambda naught by under root of 1 minus lambda naught by lambda c square. Now this is relation between guided wavelength, cutoff wavelength, and free space wavelength. Lambda g is guided wavelength, free space wavelength is lambda naught, and lambda c is cutoff wavelength, right? Now expression for, coming to next expression for lambda g, right? Vp is nothing but product of guided wavelength with its frequency, that is lambda g into f, right? Now if I can write it as c by lambda. Now the expression for vp in terms of cutoff wavelength, that is given by c by under root of 1 minus lambda by lambda c square, which is equals to lambda g into c by lambda. Now this c term will get cancelled. Now lambda g equals to lambda naught by under root of 1 minus lambda naught by lambda c square. Now this is the expression or the relation between free space wavelength, that is lambda naught, cutoff wavelength, that is lambda c, and guided wavelength, that is lambda g, right? Now this is about expression for lambda g, guided wavelength, phase velocity vp, and group velocity, that is lambda g, right? Now consider this wave, right? Now if I consider this wave, now this is nothing but low frequency signal, right? And this is nothing but high frequency signal. Envelope is nothing but low frequency signal, and in between, which is nothing but high frequency signal, right? Now if I consider this wave, always low frequency signal, right? Low frequency signal travels with group velocity, and high frequency signal travels with phase velocity. Always remember, low frequency signal, whatever the signal that is containing low frequency, now that signal is traveling with a velocity that is called as group velocity, and high frequency signal, that velocity is represented by phase velocity. Always low frequency signal, right? Low frequency signal travels with a velocity of group velocity, and high frequency signal travels with a velocity of phase velocity, right? Now this, you have to remember this point. Low frequency signal travels with a velocity, that is group velocity, and high frequency signal travels with a velocity, that is phase velocity. Now if you consider waveguide, right, always high frequency signals are allowed through it, right? That means the whatever the signal that is traveling through the waveguide, that travels with the velocity of phase velocity. Now this is about expression for lambda g, phase velocity, and group velocity, right? Now coming to next topic, wave impedance. Coming to next topic, wave impedance. In a rectangular wave impedance for a rectangular waveguide, that means rectangular waveguide supports TE mode or TM mode. Now wave impedance in TE or TM wave. Now we have to calculate wave impedance in TE or TM. Rectangular waveguide supports TE or TM wave. Now we have to find out wave impedance for TE or TM wave that is propagating through the rectangular waveguide, right? Now this wave impedance is denoted by Z to the suffix Z, right? Now this wave impedance is denoted by Z to Z. Now if you see this, now consider this. This is along x axis, this is along z axis, and this is along y axis, right? Now this wave impedance is denoted by z to z, and it is the ratio of electric field strength in one direction to the magnetic field strength in another direction, right? Wave impedance is defined as the ratio of electric field strength in one direction, one transverse direction, to the magnetic field strength along other transverse direction, right? Other transverse means perpendicular direction, right? Now the wave impedance for the TE or TM wave which are propagating along the rectangular waveguide, here we are calculating. Now the wave impedance is nothing but it is the ratio of electric field strength in one transverse direction. Transverse is nothing but perpendicular to the magnetic field strength along another transverse direction. That is, if I consider electric field strength along x-axis, obviously you will get y-axis. Or if I consider reverse, minus Ey by Hx, right? Wave impedance is the ratio of electric field strength. It is the ratio of electric field strength in one transverse direction to the magnetic field strength in another transverse direction, right? Now this is about the definition of wave impedance. Now here we have to calculate wave impedance for TE wave and TM wave, for TE wave and for TM wave. Now wave impedance, first we have to calculate for TM wave. Now the wave impedance for TM wave, that is denoted by ZTM, right? ZTM is the wave impedance representation for TM wave, right? Now the ZTM, now that is given by Ex by Hy. Now the definition of wave impedance is nothing but electric field strength in one transverse direction to the magnetic field strength in another transverse direction, right? Ex by Hy. Now what is field component Ex? We have derived, right? Starting we have derived, that is given by minus gamma by H square dou E Z by dou X minus J omega mu by H square dou H Z by dou Y. Now this is expression for, see, starting we have derived expression for Ex, Ey, Hx, Hy, Ez and Hz, right? Now the expression for Ex, that is nothing but minus gamma by H square dou Ez by dou X minus J omega mu by H square dou Hz by dou Y. Now the expression for Hy, that is given by minus gamma by H square dou Hz by dou Y minus J omega epsilon by H square dou Ez by dou X, right? Now this is about expression for Ex and Hy. Now for TM wave, right? TM wave, we know that for TM wave Ez is not equals to 0 and Hz is equals to 0, right? Ez is not equals to 0 and Hz is equals to 0, right? Transverse magnetic wave, where, right, we, from the definition we know that Ez not equals to 0 and Hz equals to 0. Now gamma propagation constant, that is nothing but alpha plus J beta. Now at microwave frequencies attenuation constant is 0. Now we will get gamma equals to J beta. Now we will get gamma equals to J beta, right? Now we have to substitute these terms in previous equation. Now ZTM, right, ZTM is given by Ex by Hy, right? Now ZTM is given by Ex by Hy. Now you have to substitute this. Now Ez is not equals to 0 and Hz equals to 0. Now this whole term will become 0. Now similarly this whole term will become 0, right? Now according to the definition of transverse magnetic wave, the magnetic field is purely perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave. Now according to the definition, we know that for TM wave Hz equals to 0 and Ez not equals to 0. Now substitute hz equals to 0, this whole term will become 0. Now substitute hz equals to 0, this whole term will become 0. Now substitute gamma equals to j bit. Right? Now finally you will get ztm equals to minus gamma by h square dou ez by dou x divided by minus j omega epsilon by h square dou ez by dou x. Right? After substituting hz equals to 0, you will get the equation for wave impedance for TM wave is this equation. Now substitute gamma equals to j beta. Right? Substitute gamma equals to j beta. Now find this minus minus will get cancelled. Now finally you will get, and h square will also get cancelled. Dou ez by dou x and dou ez by dou x also get cancelled. Finally you will get j beta by j omega epsilon. Now jj will also get cancelled. Now ztm we will get finally beta by omega epsilon. Right? Ztm finally you will get beta by omega epsilon. Now what is expression for beta? We know that omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon now divided by omega epsilon. Right? Now take omega under root omega square mu epsilon out. Here you will get 1 minus fc by f whole square. Right? Finally you will get 1 minus fc by f whole square now divided by omega epsilon. Right? Omega will get cancelled. Now you will get this epsilon, I can write it as root epsilon into root epsilon, and 1 epsilon will get cancelled. You will get under root of mu by e into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Under root of mu by e into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now what is, we have to calculate the value of mu by e. Right? Now for the rectangular waveguide that is filled with air. Right? For the rectangular waveguide that is filled with air. Now this I can mu naught into mu r divided by epsilon naught into epsilon r. Right? Now this is nothing but for air, we know that these values are 1, and here you will get 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 divided by 1 by 36 pi into 10 power minus 9. Right? Now if I calculate this, right, under root of mu by e, if you calculate this, you will get under root of 4 pi into 36 pi into 10 power into 10 square. Right? Into 10 power minus 7 into 10 power 9 you will get 10 square. Right? Under root of mu by e, here you will get 120 pi, which is nothing but 377, which is nothing but 377 ohms, which is nothing but intrinsic impedance. Under root of mu by e, which is nothing but intrinsic impedance. Now what you will get finally, ztm. Right? Finally you will get ztm, which is equals to under root of mu by e into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Right? Now the ztm, which is equals to intrinsic impedance, under root of mu by e, which is nothing but intrinsic impedance, into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now this is the expression for wave impedance. Right? Expression for wave impedance for TM mode of propagation inside the rectangular waveguide. Now for TE mode of propagation, we have to calculate for TE mode of propagation. Now for TE mode, EZ equals to 0 and HZ equals to, HZ not equals to 0. Right? Now for TE mode, EZ equals to 0 and HZ not equals to 0. Now ZTE indicates wave impedance for TE mode of propagation. Now that is given by EX by HY. Now what is EX? Right? Expression for EX that is given by minus gamma by H square dou EZ by dou X minus J omega mu by H square dou HZ by dou Y divided by HY, that is given by minus gamma by H square dou HZ by dou Y minus j omega epsilon by h square dou ez by dou x. Right? expression for Ex and expression for Hy represent it. Now substitute Ez equals to 0. This whole term will become 0, and similarly this whole term will become 0, right? And finally you will get Zte, which is equals to minus j omega mu by h square dou hz by dou y, now divided by minus gamma by h square dou hz by dou y, right? This dou hz by dou y, this dou hz by dou y will get cancelled. H square also will get cancelled. Minus will also get cancelled. And gamma is nothing but j beta, right? And finally you will get j omega mu by j beta, j also will get cancelled. Now finally you will get Zte equals to omega mu by beta, right? Zte equals to omega mu by beta. Now Zte, which is nothing but omega mu by beta, right? Omega mu by beta. Now beta, we know that expression under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon, right? Omega mu by under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon, right? Now take omega square mu epsilon out. If I take it out, you'll get omega under root of mu e 1 minus omega c square mu e divided by omega square mu e, right? This mu e will get cancelled, right? This mu will get cancelled. Now this omega will get cancelled, and here you will get under root of mu by e, right? This I can write it as root mu into root mu. One root mu will get cancelled. Finally you will get under root of mu by e, right? Under root of mu by e into 1 by under root of 1 minus omega c by omega square. Now omega c is nothing but 2 pi f c, and omega is nothing but 2 pi f. Now this is nothing but intrinsic impedance neta. Now Zte, finally you'll get neta by under root of 1 minus f c by f whole square. Now this is the wave impedance for TE mode of propagation inside the rectangular waveguide and TM mode of propagation inside the rectangular waveguide, right? Now let me briefly explain all the terms. The coming to next topic, that is wave impedance in TE or TM wave, right? We have to calculate. See, rectangular waveguide supports TE mode of propagation or TM mode of propagation. Now for this TE or TM mode of propagation, we have to calculate wave impedance, right? That wave impedance is denoted by Z to Z. Now according to its definition, it is nothing but the ratio of electric field strength to magnetic field strength, right? The ratio of, but not in one direction, right? Now coming to its definition, wave impedance is defined as the ratio of electric field strength in one transverse direction to the magnetic field strength in another transverse direction. Transverse indicates perpendicular, right? Now electric field strength in one direction, that is x-axis, and magnetic field strength in another transverse direction, that is y-axis, right? Wave impedance is the ratio of electric field strength in one transverse direction to magnetic field strength in another transverse direction, right? Now using this definition of wave impedance, we have to calculate wave impedance for TE wave in rectangular waveguide and for TM wave in rectangular waveguide, right? Now coming to first one, TM wave, right? Now the wave impedance for TM wave, that is defined by Zte, right? Now Ztm is nothing but electric field strength in one transverse direction to magnetic field strength in another transverse direction, right? Now Ztm equals to, we have derived field components for Ex, Hy and Hx, Ey and Ez and Hz. Just we are representing that field component. Now for TM mode of propagation, right, for TM mode of propagation, we know that Ez, Hz equals to 0 and Ez not equals to 0. For TM mode of propagation, we know that Hz equals to 0 and Ez not equals to 0, right, where the magnetic field is purely perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave, right? Now gamma is nothing but alpha plus j beta, and at higher frequencies alpha is 0, you'll get gamma equals to j beta, right? You'll get gamma equals to jb, right? Now substituting these values in this equation, that is hz is 0 and hz is 0. Now finally you will get ztm equals to gamma by h square dou ez by dou x divided by j omega epsilon by h square dou ez by dou x. If we calculate this, finally you will get beta by omega epsilon. Now expression for beta, we know that under root of omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon divided by omega epsilon, right? Now if you solve this, you will get under root of mu by e into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square, right? Now if you calculate the value for under root of mu by e, you will get 377 ohms, which is nothing but intrinsic impedance denoted by meter, right? And finally expression for ztm is nothing but intrinsic impedance into under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square, right? Now coming to TE mode of propagation, we have to calculate wave impedance for TE mode. Now for wave impedance for TE mode, which is given by expression EX by HY, here just reverse. There HZ is 0, here EZ is 0. Now substitute EZ equals to 0. If you solve this, finally you will get omega mu by beta. Now substitute expression for beta, right? Omega square mu epsilon minus omega c square mu epsilon. And finally, if you solve this, you will get neta by under root of 1 minus fc by f whole square. Now, what about wave impedance for TEM mode of propagation? Right? Now, what about wave impedance for TEM mode of propagation? And this is nothing but neta. Right? See, multi-conductor transmission line, why it is neta, let me explain. Now, we have one of the type of microwave transmission lines, which is nothing but multi-conductor transmission lines which contains more than one conductor. Now this multi-conductor transmission line supports TE mode of propagation, TM mode of propagation along with TEM mode of propagation, right? Now coming to this multi-conductor transmission line, this doesn't contain any cutoff frequency. Multi-conductor transmission line doesn't contain any cutoff frequency. If FC is 0, right, that means if FC is not present, now what you will get ZTM? Obviously you will get intrinsic impedance, right? We have derived, see, multi-conductor transmission lines such as coaxial lines, right, such as coaxial lines, strip lines, like, it will support TEM mode of propagation, and this doesn't contain any cutoff frequencies. Always wave impedance of TEM wave is nothing but intrinsic impedance, right? Now this is about wave impedance. Now this is about wave impedance.